certainly one of the go-to guys, if not the go-to guy, for this offensive unit.
One of the most talked about players in the league, as well as one of the most productive receivers. He attacks the football downfield.
Here we go!
And some room to maneuver. And he takes it down. Second down. On second down, Elliott. And he is not going to get in as the big bodies stop him at the one. Here's New England defensively. Last year, the number one overall defense as far as points given up goes. And they've got a lot coming back in 2017.
Now, they certainly do. And let's go back to the Super Bowl. Trey Flowers, who is their leading sack guy in 2016, had seven.
And he's going to be stopped here on this first play as he gets it to the line of scrimmage and no more. Now Brady throwing on second down. And a first hookup with his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski. The 20, 10, and all the way out to the 38-yard line. Great return. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And now last drive, so successful with the ground game, ending in a touchdown. Do you stick with that formula?
That would be the number one thing you would think of, but so many guys now would look at it and say, we've got them set up so well for play action, now's the time to take a shot.
Yeah.
But, you know, there was a big-time coach in the state of Ohio who once said, if you throw the ball...
Second down, Prescott. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. 20, 10, touchdown. Here, this will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Okay, partners, New England comes out here to take the field on offense. This is such an interesting story, how they've been able to do it year after year after year. Guys talk about parity in the NFL. Well, New England has kind of transcended that parity, and they've done it with guys that you don't normally think of as household names.
The parts keep changing for New England. That's the amazing part on offense. Running the corner, and usually he's able to use his body and catch the football, but a really nice play by the defenders, able to knock it away.
Throwing is Brady on third down. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth.
20.
In motion, Gronkowski. Here we go on fourth down now with Brady. And this is incomplete.
It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in, and that led to a big drop.
And the Cowboys will call on Dan Bailey here. On the right hash, officially, this will be a 51-yard attempt. And no, it doesn't get there. And that'll make it third down. Well, they've gone backwards so far in this series. Third and 13. Three receivers to the left, one to the right. On third and long, it's Brady. He's got a man. It's Mitchell. Three receivers to the left, one to the right. On third and long, it's Brady. He's got a man. It's Mitchell. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30.
I've got to make sure that I don't take Tom Brady's greatness for granted, that we make him routine. How about that throw right there?
And no.
Not anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
Third down here for the offense after the incomplete pass. From the gun, it's Brady. Going up top. Looking for Floyd, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Orlando Scantling. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. Here come the Patriots again on offense, the Super Bowl champions, and boy, they have been able to do it a lot of times, Charles, with unsung heroes, haven't they? Look at the names that led them through the playoffs. Hogan, White, Lewis, guys you just wouldn't think of.
Yeah, Deion Lewis, a fifth-round pick, 3 touchdowns against Houston in the divisional round. Chris Hogan, undrafted, he ends up having 180 yards in receptions, including yards or more against the Pittsburgh Steelers. And how about James White, a fourth-round pick out of Wisconsin? Think about who he played behind while he was at Wisconsin, and he turns out to be the unsung hero.
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the
run, and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Time running out here on the play clock. Now Prescott. Got a man. It's complete. Williams. They'll come up now in the Wildcat package.
Let's go. Red 38. Red 38. Black Crown. Black Crown. Black Crown. Black Crown. Black Crown. Black Crown. Ohio. Ohio. Ohio.
They find some open field here. Give them 11 yards.
With the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Come on, let's go! Red, Ohio.
Halfback sent in motion. A second down throw for Prescott. This will be caught at about the 6. Again, here's Blunt. And some room to work. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks.
That's another nice run, and I have to tell you, some of the coaches that I played for, their philosophies were always different when they see a guy running the ball well. Some of them wanted to immediately go to play action and throw it now because it's wide open. Well, other coaches said, you
carry there of 15 yards.
How many times do we say in this game is speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways. In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, and that led to a really nice game.
He's going to wind up, and Brady going to be in. And with time running down, they go down to a knee.
Seems to me, Brandon, that they're pretty content with where they are right now. Just going to take a knee and head in for the half.